recording.
We now place ourselves in the loving presence of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your spirit and they shall be created and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just and always to rejoice in His consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them was lost, except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them safe, and to keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Good afternoon, good morning, and good evening. The Lord be with you.
Good evening, Father.
In the last days of the Easter season, this is Wednesday, we have the prayer of Jesus. And the prayer is, Holy Father, I keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. But go to the last part of the prayer, and he said as well, I consecrate them to myself, I consecrate myself for them, that they may be also consecrated in truth. What a beautiful prayer of Jesus. The prayer of Jesus, first and foremost, for us all, for those believers, for the disciples, for those who follow the way. And there are those who are faithful to the Lord, and those who have subjected themselves to God's commands. And we realize that they are there, always proclaiming the gospel of Christ, always adhering to the Lord Jesus Christ. The prayer is also for those who do not belong to the world, who do not belong to Jesus, but they are in the name of Jesus with him. They do not follow him perhaps, but in the end, they try as much as possible to be with Jesus, the Lord, the Redeemer. And so these two that Jesus wanted, that they may be one in the name of the Father, just as he and the Father are one. This sense of unity, this sense of ecumenism, this sense of sacredness is always there. A valid prayer of Jesus to all of us, a valid prayer to his disciples. So much so that we should be one and not the evil one who will possess us. When we are with Jesus, we commend him, we praise him, we adore him, we bless him. And all our acts and actions, all our desires, all our endeavors are for him, really. And we do that one in the name of God. He continued, when I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave them, and I guarded them, and no one of them was lost. Yes, Jesus guarded us. Jesus protected us. Jesus, in a way, He resembles each one of us so that no one is lost except for the one who is lost in the, as the son of destruction, in order that the scriptures might be fulfilled. Only one was lost, perhaps, and this was given to him. This was all in his valid countenance. But then the whole of humanity is protected. The whole of us is undergirded by the same Jesus, so that we will be protected and we will be in labor towards the kingdom of God. So nice, no? That when Jesus protected us, when Jesus guarded us, we are not lost, but rather we are in continuous journey towards him, towards the Father. And so at the end, he would say, I consecrated them and I consecrate them in the truth. Yes, Jesus is consecrating us to the Father, the truth of life. Jesus is giving us the Father. One way or another, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And he is adhering also to the Father. The way, the cross, the truth is in the Father, and the life is the life given to us by Jesus. What a beautiful gift, what a beautiful way of adhering to him so that our life would be really in him. Jesus is praying for us. Jesus is guarding us. Jesus has consecrated us that we may live our life to the full. Amen.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you for consecrating us.
Thank you for consecrating us.
For praying us to the Father.
For praying us
that we may be one.
That we may be one.
As you and the Father are one.
As you and the Father are one.
Thank you, Lord, for guiding us.
Thank you, Lord, for guiding us.
For protecting us.
For protecting us.
So we are not lost, O Lord Jesus.
So we are not lost, O Lord Jesus.
Thank you, O Lord, for consecrating us.
Thank you, O Lord, for consecrating us.
For consecrating us to the truth.
For consecrating us to the truth.
That is telling us.
That is telling us.
The way to the Father.
The way to the Father.
The truth is the Father.
The truth is the Father.
And the life is the Father.
And the light is the Father.
Thank you, Lord, for these blessings.
Thank you, Lord, for this blessing.
We are unworthy.
We are unworthy.
But in your love.
But in your love.
We will remain in you.
We will remain in you.
Amen.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Angel of God, my guardian dear, whom God's love commits me here, I pray this baby at my side, for that I am true and died. Amen.
Amen.
Saint Hannibal,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Send, O Lord.
Holy Apostle,
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Good evening.
Amen. Good evening, Father.
Good afternoon. Good morning.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Very nice prayer.
And yes, very nice prayer of Jesus. Very, very nice.
Imagine, no, Jesus is praying for us, no, and he himself is Son of God, no, he himself is God. And yet, his prayer, Father, is like endorsing us to the Father, no?
Yes, everything.
Wow.
Endorsing us to the Father, leading us to the Father, the way he should be, we should be in this world.
Father, may question.
Yes.
Apa? Noong una kong binasa yung John 17, hindi ko masyado naintindihan ba? Sabi niya, they don't belong to the world as I belong to the world. Ano yun?
We are His disciples and we belong to Jesus. We do not belong to the world practically. But the world is where us, where we announce the gospel, where we make true the sense of brotherhood, where we make the crucifixion and death of the Lord as ours, and everything in that. So, the same as Jesus was saying, I do not belong to the world, as same as us, we do not belong to the world.
As I am to the world. Sabi ko, ano yung, they do not belong to the world as I am to the world. Yun ang catch ba doon? Sabi ko, ano yung as I am not to the, as I am to the world? Sabi ko, they don't belong as I am to the world.
Yes.
Ano yun yung pagka sabi
yung naman. Kanyang pagka-words niya doon, it's more of Him as divine. He does not belong to the world, but He is in the world. As a human person, He is in the world, but He does not belong to the world.
Now, it's clear. Thank you, Father.
Welcome. And it's a nice and beautiful thing.
Yeah.
When He told us that we don't belong to the world.
Father, yung sanctification is, ano yun, yung magiging santo.
Yes, sanctification is to believe in the Lord, to accept the Lord in our life, and to be sanctified as well.
To avoid
be sanctified sin. As well. Yeah, to avoid sin.
To avoid sin.
That's our belongingness to the Lord. Sanctification.
Is it the same as consecration, Father? No.
Consecration is He entrusted us to the Father. I consecrated you. I entrust you to the Father. So sanctification is already our sanctity.
That's why we pray, no? That's why we pray for the sanctification towards our holiness. Yun ang prayer natin towards our holiness.
We are consecrated to attain holiness, to attain sanctification.
And the prayer of... Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
No, and the prayer of Jesus, Father, is good for all humankind, no? All mankind. Hindi lang followers niya.
Yes. But of course, the followers are the ones ready to accept it. For others, they are still, Jesus is still waiting for them.
So nandiyan
it's a beautiful prayer. It's a beautiful prayer that He has entrusted to us.
And the prayer of Jesus, Father, ang isang consecration, no? And for those who are non-believers, it doesn't expire.
Yeah, no? He's waiting for them.
Waiting for them, for their conversion.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah, Father, yung bang pag, sa Holy Eucharist, yung pagtaas ng yung wine at saka host, consecration din yun.
Yes, that's transubstantiation. Transubstantiation. We are waiting for Jesus for the bread and wine to be transformed into the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Transubstantiation.
Substance, so transit.
Nasa ano yan palagi, nasa religion class natin noon. Transubstantiation.
Eh, kasi Father, high school namin, public. So, mga seminarista sa amin, minutes. Ay, nako.
But you were listening, so that's it.
Nanginginig paguro, siguro that time ang mga seminarista. Kasi sila, no? Parang excited sila na parang ano sila ba na teaching religion. Tapos mm-hmm. Tapos yung mga high school is magka-crush pa sa seminarista.
Yes.
That was high school days.
That's part of life.
High school days.
So, looking forward na makarating yung every Thursday namin noon na makalisen ba to uh-huh. seminarista na mag
so, magturo.
Magturo, oo.
That's nice.
So every time pala. Kasi yung pinintahan naming pilgrimage noon sa Our Lady of Champion Father, part at parsa si, kilala mo si Father Aitona, no?
Yep.
Yeah, Father Aitona was the director of the Lady of Good Champ sa Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Ang biggest, ano, yung last part was the consecration of Our Lady of Champ. Sabi ko, ano yung
iko-consecrate? Yeah, consecration. Yeah, you consecrate ourselves. You consecrate yourself to Our Lady of Champ to lead you to Jesus.
Akala ko si Father Mary consecrate
to na. No. You are consecrating yourselves to the Lady of Charm to lead you to Jesus and to lead you to sanctity, to lead you to holiness, to lead you to where you are. So when once you consecrate yourselves, you are more aware of it and all the things that are therein.
I see. Kami pala yun. Ay, ang tao pala yun. Akala ko si Mama Mary. Kaya nagtaka ako. Si Mama Mary. Eh, nandiyan na siya. Yung palang nag-attend ng masa, yung consecrate.
Brother, is it the same as integration? Integrate yourself to...
The change of words. To be one. But the nicest one would be consecration. Yes. Integration to the Blessed Mother, integration to Saint Joseph, but you know, consecrating is different. It has holy. The words
more of holy. Holiness.
Parang more holy siya, Father, than the consecration.
Yes,
also.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful.
One of the best ano yan, no, sa Bible, Father, John 17.
I like that one. I like that one.
Mm-hmm. Uh-uh.
John 17, the prayer of Jesus.
So sa gospel, isang question na lang, Father.
Sige,
so sa mga gospel o sa Bible natin is how many times si Jesus who prayed for us. Kasi ito ang isa-isa Our Father, ang isa is ito ngayong today's gospel, yung isa-isa during crucifixion.
Well,
so,
he has prayed for us many times, but it's not just placed in the Gospels. The one place in the Gospels are the most important ones.
So he always prays for us.
Yes, always prays for us. When he was alone, when he was in his communion with the Father, he's praying for us.
Ah, noon sa agony, no? A prayer.
The agony prayer. He prays for us. He prays for us. But the only thing in the Bible that is limited, because not all are written there.
Beautiful. Uh-huh. Jesus praying for us. No, wow.
Yes.
So Father, question lang. How many years after the death of Jesus si John.
Si John medyo late siya na matay.
Age. Parang old age si John.
Old age si Saint John, old age. Sort of 95 AD.
Kasi may isa diyan na siya yata ang natural death lang, yung iba ay talagang
yes.
Iba ang
the only one.
Iba martyrdom talaga, martyrdom.
martyrdom siya. Yung siya ang Saint John Evangelist Father, no? Kasi may isang
yes.
yung Saint John the Baptist, yun ang namatay during beheaded. The time ni Herod.
Yes,
yung pinugutan siya ng ulo. That was how many years BC, Father?
Oh, that's before the death of Jesus. So kung mga 3 years lang si Jesus, we don't know exactly the time of death, the age of John the Baptist, but he died before Jesus.
Magkaedad sila ni Jesus eh. If we think about what we have read in the Bible, magkaedad lang sila kasi nga during the visitation.
No.
Si John the Baptist.
They're not the same age, tita.
Kasi during the visitation. During the visitation, pareho silang pregnant.
Oh, sa bagay. Tama.
Kasi the baby leaps in the
Yes. Six months apart. 6 months lang.
So magkaedad sila.
Tama.
And maybe they played together. They grew up together. Kasi magkasi.
There is no
record.
No record of it.
I have read one time, Father, no, na yung mga presume lang ba, mga presuming na since they were of the same age and then nawala si Jesus, no, na talagang walang record, no, until he came back sa as public life na, no? So during that time pala na sabi nila na during 12 years old or growing up si Jesus, magkasama sila ni John the Baptist. Magkasama sila daw pag
they play together.
they were educated together, mga ganyan ba? So we don't know. So anyway,
yes,
thank
there
you,
are so many things that are written about them, but according to some sources, they have all those things as well together. So whatever be our readings, we hope to believe in it, especially if they are good writers, good readers, and the tradition, the Catholic tradition, has endorsed it. So to all of us, Jesus is praying for us. Let us make this prayer of Jesus a wonderful moment for us. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Good night. Good afternoon.
Father, thank you very much, Father.
Welcome.
God bless
you, Father.
Thank you.
Oh, Tita.
Please go ahead, Tita Helen.
Yes, po. John 17, verses 11 to 19. Jesus prayed that his disciples would be sanctified and consecrated in God's truth and holiness. In Hebrew, the word for consecration means holy or set apart for God. Second, we too are set apart by God as believers in Jesus as our Savior and Lord. We are called to live in holiness by living our lives in the way that Jesus has taught and shown us in his life and have special love for the poor and the needy. Third, the Holy Spirit is the source of all holiness. Allow the Holy Spirit to work in our lives. He can transform us into the likeness of Christ. Is your life consecrated to God? Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much for the three pointers, Tita Helen. And I think, and that ends our Zoom prayer meeting for today. And let's listen again, no? As if you have time, no? Let's listen again to the reflections of and prayers of Father Danny. Because today's gospel is, as usual, very, very beautiful. Gospel. Imagine Jesus praying for us. We are consecrated to the Father. So what a joyful feeling talaga. And joy is different from happiness. Joy is something spiritual. So knowing that Jesus prays for us or has prayed for us, no, it's a very, very joyful feeling talaga. So, amen.
Amen.
Okay. Miga Belen, please unmute yourself for the closing prayer.
Dear Lord, thank you for giving us time to gather here tonight, today. Thank you for protecting and providing opportunity to meet, learn, and grow, and rededicate this gathering to you. We pray for the attendees and whatever we do, whether in word or deed, we do it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father through Him. Thank you for blessing our time together. We give you honor and glory, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. And all together, please. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, the world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.